Hello, everybody, and welcome once again to Resident Evil 2. Last time we used our jewels to get our hands on some stone tablets. We got our hands on some more precinct keys, and we met up with Police Chief Irons. Brian Irons. Excuse me, Brian Irons. The meeting was a short one, as was our reunion with the little girl. She identified herself as Sherry before running away because she was afraid that something big and terrible was after her. Well, doesn't matter. We got some keys, we got some unopened doors, and we're gonna be finding out what's hiding behind them. Oh, man. All right. I'm not gonna take care of you right now, buddy. Later. Okay, I think we're done with these guys. There's an increment right there, but we don't need that. Oh, whoa, whoa, whoa. Ugh, come on. Shit. Okay. That's him taken care of. Anything here? Green herb. And I'm out of ammunition. Almost. Now, if I remember correctly, the code for this was 22. Oh shit. 22-36. Yes, it is. Some acid rounds for our troubles, and a police station map. Goody. Now, let's see what else we've got here. Oh, I don't know. Is this door open? Yes, it is. This is a shortcut to outside the chief's office, although we don't need to use the shortcut right now. I just wanted to check if the door was unlocked. I didn't remember if it was or not. This guy has some ammunition on him. Always useful to have. Let's see where this leads. An empty corridor. Another type of locked door, this time with a club. Now, you might have noticed that there was one other circuit breaker like this. We'll get a cord to fix this problem a little later on. Thank you. For now, we have a dog problem to take care of. Shit. Come on, you shit, where are you? Oh shit, there's two of them. Well, safe for now. There's an herb here, which we're gonna be taking, thank you very much. And not now, Skype. Not now. Now, as you can probably see, we need to regulate the power to hit the 80 mark. Each switch regulated by a certain amount. Not a difficult puzzle to solve. We'll be going there shortly. What is this? Come on, take it. Got a map of the basement of the police. No, this opens the alley. Wait. Okay. Can't open this door either. Well, too bad. Is this a dead end? Well, at least there's a... We got ourselves inside a safe room, so let's restock and resupply. Am I gonna need anything else? Well, maybe. But for now, we're good.
Sherry, I've been looking everywhere for you. I was so worried. We've got to go now, honey, okay? If we stay here, that monster will find us. Let's go.
No, I won't.
What's the matter? Don't you trust me?
It's not that, Claire. It's because of my daddy. He's over there. I heard him call my name. Daddy must have been attacked by the monsters! I have to help him!
Wait, Sherry! Don't go alone! Sherry! Sherry!
And now we play as Sherry. Interestingly enough. Let's see what Cher has in her inventory. Of course, she can't equip any weapons even if she had them. So all we can do is avoid the dogs. here we have our old buddy. The box pushing puzzle. Gotta make a makeshift bridge over there. This time it's less time consuming than it was in the first game. Come on, Sherry, push it. And well done, Sherry. You've made a bridge made of boxes over some shit water. Let's see what you get for your troubles. Ooh. Well. And we are done here. Time to go back. No. Bad doggy. Get back.
Claire! Are you there?
Sherry. Are you okay? Did you find your dad?
Yes, I'm okay. But I couldn't find him. But I did find something else for you. Here! Here's another.
Thanks, sweetie. Now, why don't you come over here? I want you to stay with me.
Reach the ventilation hole anymore. But don't worry, I'll find another way. I can take care of myself.
Wait, Sherry, come back. Sherry! Sherry!
I never liked these child character sidekicks. You get in almost every game. They're almost always more trouble than they're worth, although Sherry did make herself useful for once at least, so I guess she's okay. Gonna be needing some room now. Got a couple of keys. Leave these here. Okay. Time to head back and open the locked doors. Yeah, fuck you, dog. Oh shit! Crap.
Hey,
Holy shit. I made it alive. Okay. Now in here, we've got a couple of items. The secret with these items, the machine gun and the side pack, is this. The side pack adds two more spaces in our inventory. But I'll leave that for Leon. But with Claire, I'm gonna be getting the machine gun. Which takes up another two spaces. Because I'm gonna be needing that. Hopefully I can kill those pieces of shit before they kill me. Let's see. Or, even better, avoid them completely. Move, 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 move. Well done, Claire. Well done. Now, there was a door here. Nothing at all in the lockers. What else? Some acid rounds. Which I don't have the space for. Watchman's Diary. August 11th. I finally had the chance to see blue skies for the first time in ages, but it did little to lift my spirits. I was reprimanded by the chief for neglecting my duties while I was up on the clock tower. There's only one thing I still don't understand. The chief seemed to be more concerned about the fact that I was up on the tower rather than that I was neglecting my duties. Why was access to the tower prohibited in the first place anyway? September 5th. I recently talked to the old man who works in the scrapyard out back. His name is Thomas. He's a quiet man and really seems to enjoy chess. He even went so far as to design a special key and lock engraved with chess pieces on them for one of the doors in the disposal yard. We made plans to play chess tomorrow night. I can't help but wonder how good he is. One thing that's been bothering me about him is the way that he's always scratching himself. Does he have some sort of skin disease, or is he just rude? September 9th. Thomas was a much better player than I had imagined. I used to think of myself as a fairly decent player, but he did a pretty good job of humbling me. About the only thing I imagine that could match his skills in chess is his appetite. All the guy did was talk about food throughout the entire game. He sounded fairly healthy, but he didn't look quite right. I wonder if he's okay. September 12th. I was supposed to play another game of chess with Thomas, but we had to cancel it because he hasn't been feeling too well. He stopped by to see me, but I told him to go back and rest since he literally looked like the walking dead. He insisted that he was just fine, but I could tell he was really having problems. Come to think of it, I haven't been feeling too good myself lately. Yep, no space in the inventory. So I'll probably have to come back for this later. For now... let's make a little journey. Make a little journey and make some room. Luckily, there's a nice little chest very close by. Yeah, this one's better. Luckily, our herbs are in good supply. We're not going to be having any trouble with our health anytime soon. Even if I do play like an idiot once again. could blame the controller I'm using, but I won't. I'm supposed to know this game inside out. I shouldn't have any problems. But anyway, let's unload a little bit. Now the grenade launcher, even though it's a shittier version of Jill's bazooka in the first game, you can load it up with as many grenade rounds as you want. Or grenade or any rounds, really. You don't have the problems you had in the first game with how many rounds you could load it with. The problem we do have, though, is that the regular grenade rounds are shit. They spread out in a very, very short arc in front of you, so you have to be really close to something to hit it. Even if you do, it's not guaranteed that it'll flinch, like that licker did when I shot him with the grenades in the face, and he stabbed me right back. Still. Okay. Time to do our job. And open the rest of the doors. So that we can finally get rid of the keys we were carrying. There was a guy left alive in here. Where is he? Shit. Just use it. And I just remembered I didn't get the lighter. Okay, sorry for the edit, but I didn't want you to see me running around to get the lighter, then come back here. So let's move on. Pretty tight spaces around here, so no choice but to kill these guys. Shit. Okay, done. One key down. Second key, done away with. Let's open this door first. You fucker. Come on! Seriously, fucking shitty bowgun, man. Seriously. Now, there's a little puzzle here concerning these faucets and this little thingy here, furnace, whatever it is. I think we're supposed to turn this and this one on. No. So it's the other way around. 12, 13, 11. Wait, was that a file? No, it wasn't. Okay. So, time to get what we came here for? Yes, Claire, I noticed. Just pick it up. Good girl. Now, let's take the film. Now let's see what's behind this door that we opened earlier. What's this? It's a cord. And what's that over there? Aha, an interrogation room. Clever. Ah! Holy shit, he actually hit me. Still alive though. No problems. Okay. No space. Well, too bad. Time to close these shutters. Now, I don't know if it's time-based or what, but there's a chance that these shutters will malfunction and zombies will start pouring in. I hope it won't happen, but you never know. Probably time-based, though. We'll see. Let's just get the acid rounds and be done with this. I'll be editing some things here, because I don't want you to get bored watching me go back and forth. But for now, let's get what we came here to do. Let's get the crank. Leave the lighter, we don't need it anymore. Leave this with its buddies, which I don't... Where is it? Yeah, the blue stone's here. Put this here. Don't know if I'll be needing any of this. But... better to err on the side of caution. Got a liquor. Fuck.
Hmm.
Good. Seems like the cord worked. Now the question is there liquor up here as well? Because if there is, we're fucked. Yes, there is. That asshole. If that jump hit me, I'd be dead. Really risky what I did. Still, we're alive. So, fuck you, liquor. I do what I want. So, now we have the other half of the blue stone, and we are ready to see what the chief was hiding. So, join me next time, where we insert our stones in place and see what there is to see. Till then, thank you for watching. Take care.